Can you see my smile? I feel like a little kid. I was just like grinning so wide, I thought my face would crack.
I'm Katrina Jackson from NASA's Goddard Space Flight Center, and I'm here today at the Kennedy Space Center to watch the launch of our newest planetary science mission, OSIRIS-REx, which will study near-Earth asteroid Bennu and return a sample to Earth. The spacecraft is launching on board an Atlas V rocket, and I know I'm excited to watch my first rocket launch, so I'm curious to see how folks here are feeling about watching this new mission get off the ground. Jerusha, is this your first rocket launch?
It is, and I'm very excited about it. This is my first time here, my first launch.
It is my first time launching a rocket. Well, I'm not launching it, but other people are, but I'm watching it.
No, it's actually my second. My first one was SpaceX CRS-7.
No, this is actually the fourth rocket launch I've seen here.
No, actually, I've been to several. I've been to probably 25 different rocket launches, from Space Shuttle to Delta's SpaceX missions, so this is another one to add to the belt for me.
And what makes you excited about watching a rocket launch?
What doesn't make you excited about watching a rocket launch? I hear that you're gonna feel the shock waves and the sound waves.
It's just the feeling, right? Like seeing it, all right, there's a small speck out there. And then being able to witness it as a very visceral event where you feel the ground shaking and you almost can taste it. You know, it's the most amazing thing I've ever seen.
I love rockets. I love space exploration. I love what NASA's doing. And of course, there's nothing more amazing than watching a rocket take off.
I expect it to be a very emotional experience, you know, to see a rocket actually go up into space, to go to an asteroid. It's the first time we've done this. So I expect it to be emotional and just awe-inspiring, you know, as what we can do as human beings when we actually put our minds to it.
Once you see it, it'll live with you for the rest of your life. There's no other way to say it. From hearing the sound, from feeling the power of the rockets, and just overall, you really grasp what NASA is doing by sending a rocket into space. I mean, it literally is rocket science. They're doing phenomenal things.
Where did you get your suit here?
I got this at the Visitor Center gift shop. It's awesome.
Well, I think I should get myself one of those one of these days.
They come in blue too, but orange, gotta go with the orange.
Why do you think this is so monumental for space exploration?
Well, there's going to be a lot learned. I think when we can get material from an asteroid back on Earth and study it properly here on Earth, that's going to be much more effective than, you know, sending a probe out there that has limited instruments and trying to study it out there.
The fact that we are going to an asteroid for the first time and actually taking a sample and bringing it back home, you know, so that itself is just amazingly exciting. It's, what are we going to learn from this sample?
Asteroid Bennu is a carbonaceous asteroid, and so it could contain amino acids and organic compounds that we haven't seen before based on other smaller pieces of meteorites.
I mean, we're going to learn a lot about asteroids, where they come from, who we are. There's a lot of questions that are going to be answered, and I'm sure there's going to be a lot of things that we're still going to question after this.
How's your experience been here at Kennedy so far?
Fantastic. It's like NASA Social has given us such access to all of the scientists and even the administrator of NASA, Charlie Bolden. So it's amazing.
It's a phenomenal experience. I cannot say enough about NASA Social and what they've given us the opportunity-wise.
I've really had a great time at NASA for over the past couple days. I'm an artist, so I'm definitely going to incorporate my experience here in some future work.
Good luck with watching the launch, and and maybe we'll check back with you afterwards.
Sounds good.
Status check.
Go Atlas.
Go Centaur.
Go OSIRIS-REx.
Everyone is go. Standing by for launch. 10 seconds. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And liftoff.
Oh my gosh!
OSIRIS-REx. A 7-year mission to boldly go to the asteroid Bennu and back.
The rocket just like, you could see it lifting off and all the smoke, and then like a couple seconds later, then you could hear the sound just like roll in towards you, and it got louder and louder. It was awesome.
It's like so bright. The brightness just gets me. I'm like, there's no other white light like that. And the, like, when that bass comes to, that sound rushes up, oh my god, it was just, I want to like cry. It was just magical. I think everyone needs to see that to put a lot of things in perspective.
Program is complete. Boosters throttled down.
point. The Atlas rocket carrying OSIRIS-REx has gone supersonic. Standing by to pass through Max-Q, maximum aerodynamic pressure.
I was really sweaty and excited. It's not, like, I'm not even on this mission. Like, this is, like, I'm so invested in it at this point. So, like, watching it go off, I was just like, oh, and it makes you feel so small.
I feel like a little kid. I was just, like, grinning so wide, I thought my face would crack. It's amazing. It's, I don't even know what to say.
Our altitude is 14 miles. Downrange distance 9 miles. Hard loss 7,400.
Now that OSIRIS-REx has safely made its way to space, I'm sure many of the team members will take a well-deserved rest tonight and settle in for the spacecraft's 2-year cruise to asteroid Bennu. Meanwhile, you can follow along with the mission online at nasa.gov/OSIRIS-REx and on Twitter at OSIRIS-REx and with the hashtag #ToBennuAndBack. OSIRIS-REx will swing by Earth in September of next year for a gravity assist, will arrive at Bennu in August 2018, will collect a sample in July 2020, and will return to Earth in September 2023. So it's going to be a long and exciting ride, and we are excited that all of you are able to come along for the journey.